disciples over the brook Cedron, where was a garden into which he entered with his disciples. Judas also, which did betray him, knew the place full well, for Jesus resorted thither oft together with his disciples. Therefore Judas, having received a band of men and of officers from the chief priests and the Pharisees, he cometh thither with lanterns, torches, and with weapons. Therefore Jesus, knowing all things that were to come upon him, he went forth and said unto them, Whom seek ye? And they answered him,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus of Nazareth, Jesus of Nazareth, Jesus of Nazareth.
Jesus saith to them,
I am he.
Judas also, which did betray him, was standing with them. As soon then as he had said, I am he, they went backward and fell to the ground. Then asked he them a second time,
Whom seek ye?
Again they answered,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus of Nazareth.
But now I am he. If ye seek for me, let these men go their way.
Peter, having a sword, he drew it out and smote at the high priest's serving man and cut his right ear off, and his name was Malchus. Then said Jesus to Peter,
Put up thy sword in the scabbard. Shall I not drink the cup which now my Father hath given me, the cup which now my Father hath given me.
Took hold of Jesus and bound him fast and led him away at first unto Annas, who was Caiaphas' father-in-law, which that same year was the high priest. Now it was Caiaphas who had counseled the Jews that it was expedient that one man should die for the people.
Oh,
Simon Peter followed Jesus afar off with another disciple. The disciple was known unto the high priest, and entered in with Jesus to the palace of the high priest. Simon Peter stood outside at the door, and then that other disciple, who was known unto the high priest, went out and spake unto her that kept the door, and brought Peter also within. Then saith the maid that kept the door to Peter,
"Art thou not also one of this man's disciples?"
He said,
"I am not."
Officers and the servants that stood there had made them a fire of coals, for it was cold. and warmed themselves. Peter also stood among them and warmed himself. Then did the high priest Annas question Jesus of his disciples and of his doctrine. Jesus made answer to him,
I always spake openly and freely to the world, and at all times I have taught within the synagogue and in the temple, whither the Jews always do resort. Nor have I spoken in secret at all. Why dost thou ask me of this? Ask ye rather them who have heard me speaking what I have said and what I have taught them. See now, for they themselves know all the things that I have said.
And when he had thus spoken, an officer who was standing by struck Jesus with the palm of his hand and said,
Dost thou dare me counsel unto the high priest so?
Jesus answered unto him,
If I have spoken evil, then do thou bear witness of the evil. But if I have spoken well, why smitest thou me?
Said they unto him, and
some consolation. Ah, we'll find some consolation. Ah, my soul, where shall I hide my shame? Ah, my soul, where shall I hide my shame? Ah, my soul, where shall I hide my shame? Where shall I hide my shame? Ah, my soul, where shall I hide my shame? Where find some consolation? Where shall I hide my shame, my shame? Where find some consolation? Where find some consolation? Till the mountaintops fall on me in desolation. Shall I stay, till the mountaintops fall on me in desolation?
Not into the judgment hall, lest they should become defiled, but that they might eat the Passover. And then went Pilate out unto them, and said,
What accusation bring ye now against this man?
And they answered and said unto him,
If this man were not a murderer,
Thank you.
him away and judge him according to your law.
The Jews therefore said unto him,
For us it is the test of Lord.
Dost thou say this of thyself, or rather did others tell it thee of me?
And Pilate answered him,
Am I a Jew? The chief priests and thine own nation have delivered thee unto me. What hast thou done?
And Jesus answered him,
My kingdom is not of this world. My kingdom of this world, then my servant truly would be fighting, that I should not be delivered unto the Jews. But now is my kingdom not from hence. At this time that I release one unto you, will ye then that I should release the king of the Jews?
Then cried they all with one accord, saying,
Not this man, none of this, not this, not this, but Barabbas, not this, not this, but Barabbas, Barabbas.
Now this Barabbas was a robber. Then Pilate therefore took Jesus and scourged him.
Oh.
the soldiers had plaited him a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and put on him a purple robe, and said,
thou not to me? Knowest thou not that I have the power to crucify and also the power to release thee?
Jesus answered him,
thou couldest have no power over me
had it not been given unto thee from above. Therefore, he that delivered me unto thee hath the greater sin.
And from thenceforward Pilate sought that he might release him.
Therefore they
took Jesus and led him away. And he bore his cross and went forth to a place that is called the place of a skull, which is called in the Hebrew Golgotha.
Crucified they him,
Pilate also wrote out a title and put it upon the cross, and there was written, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews. This title then read many of the Jews, for the place was nigh unto the city where Jesus was crucified. And it was written in Hebrew, and in Greek, and in Latin also. Then said the chief priests of the Jews unto Pilate,
Christ thou must,
Christ thou must,
Christ thou must.
Shall stay as I have written.
Had crucified Jesus, take his garments and make four parts, unto each of the soldiers there a part, and also his coat. Now the coat was without a seam, and from the top was woven through and through. They said therefore one to another, might be fulfilled, which is written, they took my raiment and they parted it among them, and for my vesture, yea, my coat, did they cast lots. These things, therefore, for the soldiers did then. Now standing beside the cross of Jesus was his mother, and also his mother's sister, Maria, Cleophas' wife, also Mary Magdalena. And when Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by her, whom he loved, saith he to the disciple,
behold, behold thy mother.
After this, Jesus, knowing that all was accomplished that was written in the scriptures, he said,
I thirst.
Now there was a vessel full of vinegar. They filled therefore a sponge with the vinegar, and placing it upon an hyssop, they poured it up to his mouth. And when Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said,
it is fulfilled.
Thank you. Judah put the fight. The Lion of Judah put the fight. The Lion of Judah put the fight. And I prevailed, and I prevailed, and I prevailed. The Lion of Judah put the fight. The Lion of Judah put the fight. And I prevailed, and I prevailed.
Suffering Thank you.
because it was the preparation that the bodies should not remain upon the cross on the Sabbath day. For that same Sabbath day was an high day. Came they unto Pilate, beseeching their legs might be broken, and that they might be taken away. Then came the soldiers, and broke the legs of the first one, and the other which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus, and they saw that he was already dead, then did they break not his legs, but one of the soldiers then pierced his side with a spear. And forthwith came there out water and blood. And he that did see these things, he also bare record, and his record is true. And he knoweth full well that he saith true, that he might believe. For all these things were done, that the scriptures might then be fulfilled. A bone of him shall not be broken. Again in the scriptures another saith, and they shall look on him whom they have pierced. Joseph of Arimathea, who was also Jesus' disciple, but secretly for fear of the Jews, went to a Pilate to beg for the body of Jesus, and Pilate gave him leave. Therefore came he thither and took the body of Jesus away. And also there came Nicodemus, he who at first had come to Jesus in the night, and brought a mixture of myrrh and of aloes, about 100 pounds in weight. And then they took the body of Jesus and wound it in the linen clothes with the precious spices, as the Jewish manner is to bury. Now there was in the place where he was crucified a garden, and in the garden a new tomb, wherein was never man yet laid.
the Jewish preparation day, because the tomb